Hey, how's it going? Brian Bowman here, and in this video, I want to talk to you about how to increase your profit. If you sell physical products, if you sell any product, you want to be able to command premium pricing. You don't want to compete on price. There is absolutely no competitive advantage to being anything other than the lowest price. And if you're going to be the lowest price, if you're going to be sort of the Walmart of your industry, or you're the low price leader, then you better have a business that's built to scale low prices. And honestly, even then, you really don't want to position yourself as the lowest price. And with the right strategies and the right understanding of how to present your price and how to minimize price, you can absolutely command premium pricing and ultimately protect your profits, which is going to allow you to suffocate your competition because it forms a virtuous cycle. The more profitable you are, the more you can reinvest, the more you can go out and acquire more customers, and this cycle starts. So let's talk about it. And actually, not to mention, the more profitable you are, the more money you have to reinvest back into your customers to make them more loyal customers so they keep coming back. So for a lot of reasons, being able to increase your profitability and to protect your profits, it's just good for everyone. It's good for you, it's good for your customers. So let's talk about it. So it happens right now. We're gonna dive into it right now. So grab a pen and paper and let's actually dive into some strategies that you can use. So the number one thing to think about is your unique value proposition. Now, I'm sure you've heard of the unique selling proposition, right? Your USP. Why should I do business with you given all the other competition that's out there? And this is a question you always want to be asking yourself. But when you're talking about protecting your profits, you want to think about value proposition. So I'm going to write this down. So this is your UVP, which is your unique value proposition. And there's two things. Write this out, proposition. And there's two things that you want to keep in mind. Your job with your UVP is to present your price, right? You have to present how much you're going to charge, and you have to minimize your price. So you're presenting your price and minimizing your price, because you have one objective that you always have to keep in mind. Your objective is to make the ownership benefit of your product so high that it makes the price of your product virtually free. So again, you want to make the ownership benefit so high that it dwarfs the price. It minimizes price so that it becomes a non-issue. If your thing is $30, $40, $50, whatever it is, $100, but the ownership benefit, if you're able to present it in a way that it's so high, the price can become a non-issue, right? The upside is so high for the buyer. And that's called comparing price versus value. So your job when you present the price is to minimize it by making the value as high as possible. And this is something that sounds subtle, but very few sellers understand how to do this, especially with physical products. They just sort of present the product. Here are the features. Sometimes they don't even talk about the benefits. They're just like, you know, this is the stitching we use, it's amazing, and here's the price. I mean, it's very, very straightforward, and that's where there's a huge opportunity for you in any business, but especially with physical products. So a few things to keep in mind when you're presenting this price. You can absolutely, I'm gonna write in a couple different colors here, you can absolutely, I'm gonna put tangibles and talk about this first. You can absolutely show that you have more value, because at the end of the day, let's just get this clear. People pay, they take money out of their wallet and they buy something. All of us do this because we see the money in our wallet as less valuable, as having less value than the thing we're going to buy. So our job is to increase the value of the thing we're selling, right? Now we can do that with tangible things. For example, bundling. We all know we can bundle products. And if we bundle them with more tangible things, then, you know, buy three and you save money. Like, this is more valuable because the sum of the parts is more valuable. And not even just multi-packs, the way that the things work together in a bundle, right? The synergy between them. This can make it, these are the tangible products that we can put together that increase the value of the offer, of what we're presenting. But one thing that a lot of people ignore are the intangibles. And this is really what I want to talk about, because this costs money, especially with physical products. If you have three of them, well, it cuts into your profit, right? Because you have to reduce the price to sort of show more value. You could create an offer that's has synergy within them. So, you know, you get the bands and the chalk and the, you know, I don't know, the jump rope or whatever. Like, together it forms a workout. So that way there's more value together. But the way to really protect profits, the way to really increase profitability is by focusing on the intangibles in your offer. So what do I mean by that? So the first is status. And I've got, and some of these might apply more readily to your product, so I've got a few here that I want you to consider. The first is status. One of my early mentors that I learned a ton from was Perry Belcher, and he says that every decision people make when they buy something is a status decision. They are either, they're making a decision whether something increases their status or decreases it, and that's it. And I want you to think of examples, because pretty much everything people are deciding, we're all doing this, does this increase my status or decrease it? So if you can position your product in a way that increases the buyer's status, that starts adding value, which starts increasing profitability because it doesn't take any more tangible things. Does that make sense? The next is bragging rights. Now, I know this sounds a little bit vain, but trust me, we all are susceptible to this, okay? Bragging rights. Absolutely, owning your product, there's certain bragging rights. Again, certain products this might apply to more, but I want you to think of it. I'm just giving you ideas on ways that you can start adding value while at the same time, you know, increasing that profitability with intangibles. The next is speed. This is huge, okay? If you can get me a result faster, I will absolutely pay more. All of us will. All of a sudden, the price starts getting dwarfed because you're saving time. Time is the most valuable thing we all have. And if you can save me time, I will absolutely pay more because your product just became more valuable. I talk about this a lot, how we can combine a lot of different elements where we have the physical product, but we bundle in a community or a challenge or something that helps accelerate the result, which now your thingamabob becomes way more valuable to me because you're going to get me a result faster. The next intangible is convenience. And this is huge. There's surveys that have been done. The last one I read was 82% of buyers are willing to pay more if it gives them more convenience. So people will absolutely pay more for convenience, again, because it increases the value. It's time, it's frustration, it's everything else. You know, people will pay for frustration-free packaging, right? Rush delivery, whatever it might be, and that's kind of speed and convenience. But there's a lot of different ways that this can be applied. So my challenge to you, and what, again, this is great theory, but I really want you to apply this and get results from it, is to think, to protect your profits, to really, insulate yourself from competition and not have to worry about pricing and actually be able to command premium pricing. I want you to be thinking, how can I increase the value so high that price becomes a non-issue? Because there's such a huge ownership benefit to my product. And this is your unique value proposition. You can absolutely look at tangibles, but I want you to also look at intangibles because you combine these two together and that's how you're able to skyrocket your profit. So go apply this and I will see you in the next video. All right, have a great day. Talk soon.